Hello, Meow. I'm Master Tofu Flower and welcome to my crafting channel. I will keep posting videos, so please subscribe and turn on your notification button so you don't miss any of my videos. In this video, I will briefly talk about the history of Nagoro Nuri. Then I will show you how to make a Nagoro Nuri style fountain pen. Nagoro Nuri is originated from Nagoroji Temple in Iwate City, Wakayama Prefecture, for at least 800 years. It is characterized by bright vermilion urushi with black scratch marks, giving it an aged look. Nagoro Nuri lacquerwares were made by the crafters and monks in the temple. The pigment of vermilion is made from precious natural cinnabar, which is as expensive as gold. Hence, Nagoro Nuri lacquerwares were only used by high-ranking monks. In 1585, Nagoroji buildings were burned down by Toyotomi Hideyoshi. As a result, many crafters and monks left Nagoro and moved to Hainan, Kuroe, Wajima, Satsuma, spreading the technique across the country. Nagoroji Temple was rebuilt in 1623. This is the location of Nagoroji Temple. Nagoroji Temple is beautiful! Meow! Toyotomi Hideyoshi is a cat in modern games! Traditionally, Nagoro Nuri is made by preparing the substrate with Honkatachi primer. Then, several layers of black urushi are applied. Typically, there's only one layer of genuine vermilion urushi top coat. Usually, the top coat is unpolished, leaving obvious brush marks on the surface. After decades of use, vermilion lacquer gradually wears down and a black lacquer layer is exposed, which gives a beautiful aged look. Traditionally, Nagoro Nuri is usually matte with brush marks. The scratch marks look more natural. However, genuine vermilion is mercury sulfide, which is both expensive and toxic. Modern Nagoro Nuri style lacquerware is very different. It should not be called Nagoro Nuri.
Modern Nagoro Nuri style. Similar to the dark side, it is faster, easier, but unnatural.
Similarly, substrate is prepared with primer, but it is not specific to Honkatachi primer. Again, several layers of black urushi are applied on the primer. However, synthetic vermilion pigment, usually quinacridone based, is used instead of mercury sulfide. The synthetic vermilion urushi is semi-transparent, so multiple layers may be needed. Also, the scratch marks are made by sanding and scraping. Finally, the Nagoro Nuri style lacquerware is polished to high gloss. As you can see, modern Nagoro Nuri style lacquerware is usually gloss and the scratch marks look less natural. I will now show you how to make a modern Nagoro Nuri style fountain pen. To make this pen, you will need a fountain pen prepared with Honji primer. I'm using Parker Jotter fountain pen. Please watch our Honji primer tutorial for more details. Concentrated vermilion urushi that we made in our colored urushi video. Kijilo urushi, black urushi, Kijomi urushi, Shin Yoshino paper, furo that is set at 20 degrees Celsius and 70% humidity, palette knife, brushes, sandpapers, one each for 1800 grit, 4000 grit, and 8000 grit. Titanium oxide powder. Kikumoru paste. Fine low ira migaki powder. Vegetable oil. Gloves. Water. Washing up liquid. Cotton. Remember to wear your gloves and keep your room well ventilated. Stay safe. Meow. A modern Nagoro Nuri typically consists of one black base layer, 1 to 2 middle black layers, and 1 to 2 vermilion top layers. Then, it is sanded with 1800 to 2000 grit sandpaper to create the scratch marks. Maybe ask your cat to help.
Meow.
It will be useful to watch my colored urushi, plain black urushi, and urushi brush videos before you start. I've explained some of the techniques in more details. Step 1. Filter your black urushi with two layers of Shin Yoshino paper. Clean and prepare your brush. paint the base layer of black urushi. Let it cure in the furo for one day. Step 2. Wet sand the pen with 1800 grit sandpaper. Wash and dry it. Step 3. Paint the middle layer of black urushi. Let it cure in the furo for one day. Step 4. Wet sand the pen with 1800 grit sandpaper. Wash and dry it. You might need to repair the dents and defects with black urushi or sabi urushi. Sand it and apply a second middle layer. The middle layer must be smooth. My servant is skillful, so we can skip the second middle layer. Step 5. Rub on a thin layer of kijomi urushi. Step 6. Mix 2 parts concentrated vermilion urushi with 1 part kijila urushi and filter it with 4 layers of shin yoshino paper. Paint the first top vermilion urushi. Cure it for 7 days. Keep the humidity of the furo below 75% or the color will be very dark. If your skill is good, the color of the urushi should be even and the surface should be smooth but not perfect. The traditional Nagoro Nuri stops at this step. Step 7. Wet sand the pen lightly with 4000 grit sandpaper. Then wash and dry it. Step 8. Paint the second layer of vermilion urushi and cure it for 14 days. Step 9. To make the scratch mark, wet sand the pen with 1800 grit sandpaper until you can see the black middle layer. Do it subtly on the location prone to starch and damage. It will have a natural look. It is important to know when to stop. This is how it's look like. For the high gloss finish, we rub on 5 layers of kijomi urushi. It is a repetition of rub on urushi, wipe off excess, curing, and buffing with polishing paste. A few people have asked me about polishing materials, so I will do a video to explain it in more details. Step 10. Rub on the first layer of kijomi urushi. Wipe off the excess and let it cure for 2 days. Make the polishing paste by mixing titanium oxide with vegetable oil. Buff the pen with the paste. Then, wash it with washing up liquid and dry it. Step 11. Repeat the last step once for the second layer. Step 12. Rub on the third layer of kijomi urushi. Wipe off the excess and let it cure for 2 days. Make the polishing paste by mixing fine La Ila Migaki powder with vegetable oil. Buff the pen with the paste. Then, wash it with washing up liquid and dry it. Step 13. Again, rub on the fourth layer of Kijomi Urushi. Wipe off the excess and let it cure for 2 days. Buff the pan with Kikumaru paste. Then wash it with washing up liquid and dry it. Step 14. Finally, rub on the fifth layer of Kijomi Urushi. Wipe off the excess. It is so shiny, meow. Let it cure for 5 days. Step 15. Now, you can reassemble your modern Negoronuri style fountain pen. Your pen is ready. I love the aged look. Meow meow. The winner of our cat paw Kalanuri pen is Samantha. Instagram name is Tart and Craft. Well done. There are 17 cat paws on the pen. There will be more giveaway Urushi pen in the future, so subscribe and click the notification button. Next time, I will show you how to do a Tamenuri pen. If you have any questions, leave a comment down below. And if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up and share our videos to your friends. See you next time. Stay tuned. Meow.